I'm really excited to be here. I'm hoping Dr. Lee can reconstruct me the way I was meant to be.
So I'm just going to take your temperature.
Okay. I've gone through dermatologists growing up, and they swore to me that this was going to fix the problem, this was going to fix it. And so far, they've all come up short. And, you know, I've seen Dr. Lee do marvelous work on a lot of different people. If she can't do it, I don't know who could.
Hello.
Hello.
Are you Steven?
I'm Steven.
Hi, nice to see you out here. I'm
see
Dr.
You.
Lee. Welcome. I'm gonna take my mask off, that's why we're out here. Do you wanna take yours off? Up to you. Okay. What brings you here? Your nose.
My nose.
Okay, do you know what this is?
Well, I've learned over the years it's Rhinophyma.
Okay. So Rhinophyma is associated with rosacea, and it's sort of a form of rosacea, but it typically happens in the nose, and you get a thickening of the skin, and it's really oily.
Yep.
How long have you had it?
About 10 years. So over the last couple of years, it seems to accelerate. I'm on camera all the time doing live shows on the internet.
So video. You see yourself.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah. But you know, you can't hide something that's big.
Yes.
It's obvious even from where I'm sitting that Steven's got rhinophyma. I mean, he has an enlarged nose. And the fact that his rosacea is still active is an issue because that's what is helping to sort of propagate his rhinophyma. Who knows when that will sort of burn out or whether that will be active throughout his long life and his rhinophyma gets worse.
Yes, this looks like rhinophyma.
Okay.
Lift your head up for me for a minute here. So yeah, you can kind of see where it's different. So we can remove a lot of this rhinophyma and try to reshape your nose. But my main concern really is I see that you're still pretty active here. Do you use anything right now for your rosacea? Do you try anything treatment? Because it's still active. Do you know what I mean? You're getting these red bumps like that, you know?
I'm gonna try to treat Steven's rhinophyma using my surgical electrocautery tool to really shave this down and re-sculpt his nose. But in Steven's case, I'm also looking at his active rosacea and making sure that whatever I do doesn't exacerbate that and also trigger more growth of his rhinophyma.
Let's see if we can't do something for you here.
I'm excited.
Okay?
I'm excited.
Okay. See you in a little bit, okay?
All right, thank you.
Of course.
Dr. Lee explained to me that I also have rosacea flare-ups, so it's good. It's good to know that. But right now, the biggest hope that I have is she doesn't run into any kind of complications because of that. I'm trying to keep the faith, you know?
All right, sweetie, you ready?
I think so.
I think you're
I'm
ready,
still
too.
Here.
Okay. I'm gonna do a little on top here first, make sure nothing ever hurts.
Steven's case is more complicated because of the fact that his rhinophyma projects anteriorly or outwards, kind of like a Pinocchio nose in a way. When someone just has a natural kind of progression extending from the nose, it's a little harder to know when exactly to stop. I just have to make sure I'm not taking too much.
You okay, right?
Absolutely.
Please also tell me if you feel like something's wearing off, because I can always give you more. Pesky vessel that wants to ooze.
I blame somewhat the active rosacea that he has because rosacea leads to increased blood vessels, increased vasculature in the superficial part of the skin, so those blood vessels are dilated.
Can't see what I'm doing so easily. I'm trying to control it here.
Blood vessel?
Because, you know, all this blood is supplying this area so that it can grow, and so the bigger it is, the bigger the blood vessels that have to supply it.
Right.
There's a blood vessel that's causing me a lot of problems. It is really something that I have to keep coming back to and keep trying to zap and keep trying to cauterize, and it's slowing me down. It's really making it difficult to see what I'm doing, and I have to keep stopping the progression of clearing this rhinophyma to zap this blood vessel.
It wants to ooze everywhere I go. Doing the same thing over and over again. I block it one way and it just comes at me somewhere else. Think non-bleeding thoughts, please. Okay, much better. Oh, thank goodness. Looking better.
thankfully, I got that spot under control that it was bleeding. It was really tough for a while. I would zap one area and stop it from oozing, and then another would sprout out. So finally, it seems like the whole area is under control, so I can move on to the other side.
Starting to really look like something.
I'm making good progress on Steven's nose, no bleeding now, so I can really concentrate on shaving this nose down, really sculpting it so that it looks as close to his original nose as possible.
Well, at least we're getting it down to the shape you want to. Looking good now.
Much better. All right.
That is ready.
It took some really careful sculpting, but I think I'm finally satisfied with the results here. When the swelling goes down, it's going to be revealed whether his nose has been properly shaped or not. So I'm hoping that he's going to do really well, but you never really know with rosacea.
So remember, this is like swollen.
Yeah.
You can see the overall shape is good. Look at the size of your nostrils. They've opened up.
Oh, I can feel a difference.
But imagine, again, it's still puffed,
yes.
Obviously.
I know it's really swollen right now, but still night and day difference. I'm very excited. I feel like I've got a new lease on life. I'm really excited to see how the world receives it when I go back live. And you know, you waited all this time, and now all of a sudden it's like, wham, it's here, it's done. Now go enjoy life.
We will put you on some anti-rosacea medications. One of the newer thoughts is that there's a mite that lives on our skin, all of us.
Oh, okay.
It's called a Demodex mite. There's a thought that people that have bad rosacea have more of these mites on their face. So we actually use an anti-mite medicine, a cream, to help to decrease the count of these mites on our skin.
I don't know if many people realize that there are mites that live on our skin. I'm talking about bugs, parasites. There's one in particular called the Demodex mite that lives in the skin of our face, and we believe that maybe these mites are a cause of rosacea. So some people with rosacea we're finding have more of these mites living on their skin.
So let's try that and see if that works.
Absolutely.
Dr. Lee said that I should take some medication to keep the rosacea under control so I don't have outbreaks, so I don't end up having a problem again in the future. The ball comes into my court, so I'm gonna do it. You know, I wanna do the preventative steps.
Thank you so much.
You're so welcome. I'm excited to see the results.
I won't be ashamed to be around my kids, my wife. They've helped me to realize, don't wait till it's out of control. Deal with it in the beginning. Life will be a lot simpler.
Oh boy, so what are we playing now?
Since I saw Dr. Lee about a month ago, my life has changed. I can breathe again. I'm not the center of attention. Well, my nose isn't the center of attention. I was nervous about my kids accepting that there was going to be a change. But I learned, as well as they learned through this process, that it's okay to make a change if it means better life. The medication that Dr. Lee prescribed is working, and my rosacea is getting under control, and so I'm gonna continue taking it, and I'm super excited about it.